And now Barry Tompkins takes a look at the Patriot quarterback, Tony Eason.
As the Patriots prepared to begin a season which would end as the most successful in their history, head coach Raymond Berry called on third-year quarterback Tony Eason to lead the charge. Steve Grogan, the Patriots starter for most of his 11 NFL years, would also play a part as Eason's backup.
I told the media, you know, before the season ever started, that in my opinion, we had one of the best situations of any team in the NFL. We had two quarterbacks that could take us all the way, and that's the way I believe. I had no idea when I said that was going to end up being the case, because they both have.
Tony Eason had been an outstanding quarterback at Delta High School in Clarksburg, California. Population, 600+. Tony's brother, Bo, was also a standout player at Delta. Both made it to the NFL, but neither attracted the attention of major college recruiters.
At that time, major colleges weren't interested, and they still aren't interested in kids that come from small high schools. They don't believe that they can play big-time football or competitive football with the kids who've come from larger schools. And at that time, I think Tony was just overlooked.
Tony Eason finally made it to a major college, Illinois, and became a Heisman Trophy candidate. But only after Coach Mike White took a special trip at a friend's suggestion to watch Tony play junior college ball. White took one look, and Eason headed for Champaign. When his college career ended, the quarterback from the small town that nobody wanted was the New England Patriots' number one pick in 1983. Eason stepped into an ideal situation. Steve Grogan, the incumbent quarterback's years, were numbered. He knew he would get his chance to play soon enough while having the luxury of time to sit behind Grogan and watch.
I'm trying to help without being too much help. A lot of times you can get too many people yakking at you, and a lot of them aren't making sense. So if I've got something important to say, I tell him, and if I don't, I stay away from him and let him collect his thoughts.
In 1985, Eason had the starting job all wrapped up. Or at least that's the way it seemed. But if you were a fan of the New England Patriots or even a member of the offensive team, you had to make sure not to blink. Game 6, Eason out with a separated shoulder. Grogan comes in, wins 6 straight. Game 12, Grogan falls with a fractured tibia. Eason finishes, 3 playoff wins and an AFC title.
Tony Eason may not have a veteran savvy, but for him and the Patriots, only one game remains.
Now, they're a very fine football team. I only can talk about their defense. They're probably the best in the NFL, without a doubt, bro. I mean, they got some great talent, and they got a great scheme, and Buddy Ryan coaches them up very well, and they all know where they're supposed to be. So we got our work cut out for us.
Grogan will be on the sidelines, disappointed, knowing he probably won't see any action in a game in which he's dreamed of playing, but feeling confident that his team's future is in young but capable hands.
Well, there's a look at both quarterbacks, Jim McMahon of the Chicago Bears, Tony Eason of the Patriots.